Hello students, welcome to my channel Agriculture Engineering Online. This is another question from GATE 2012. It is a common question which is combining question number 52 and 53 from the Farmation and Power. The question says soybean is to be planted with a precision planter that meters 54 seeds per revolution of the metering disc powered from a ground wheel of diameter 49 mm. The desired plant population is 44,800 per hectare with a root to root spacing is 0.75 meter. The germination percentage is 84. The planter is to be operated at 2.5 km per hour with a 10% speed of ground wheel. The angular speed of the ground wheel in RPM is 4 options are given. And the angular speed ratio of metering disc to ground wheel for obtaining the desired plant population is 4 options are given: 0.125, 0.15, 0.225, and 0.250:1. So let us go to the solution part. First part is the, let us see, this is the precision planter where soybean is to be planted. It is having the rotor, disc rotor, metering device. So let us, the planter speed is given 2.5 km per hour. The planter is to be operated at 2.5 km per hour. And skid is given 10%. 10% skid means, so if the planter moves 2.5 km per hour, that means the ground wheel, this ground wheel is skidding. So that means the ground wheel actual speed is less, but the speed of travel is more. So that is why this skids. Therefore, the planter speed is 2.5 km per hour and the ground wheel speed will be equal to 2.5 divided by 1.1. That means less speed, that is 2.272 km per hour. This is the peripheral speed of the ground wheel. Then ground wheel diameter is given 0.49 meter. So we know that if the n is the RPM of the ground wheel, then pi d n into 60 by 1000, then because it's in hour per hour, pi d n, n is the RPM, revolution per minute, so into 60 is the revolution per hour, you can say. Then pi d n by 60 divided by 1000 is for kilometer, because d in meter, n is RPM. So if you put this into the equation, then the peripheral speed of the ground wheel will be equal to, already it's decided here, 2.272, and you have to equate with this one. If you equate, then you can find out the revolution of the, or you can say angular speed of the ground wheel. So therefore, the angular speed of the ground wheel from this equation, that is pi into 0.49 into n into 60 by 1000 will be equal to 2.5 divided by 1.1. So directly we can take it from here. So therefore, the n will be equal to 24.6 RPM. So therefore, the angular speed of the ground wheel is equal to 24.6 RPM. This is the first part of the question, question number 49. So next, coming to the question, that is next part. So if you see the ground wheel, so the desired spacing first we need to find out. The desired spacing we know, so per hectare, it is to be told that actually 84% is the germination, and 44,800 is the number of plants in per 1 hectare, and is the 75, that is 0.75 meter is the width of the planter. That means if you multiply 0.75 into 44,800, so that is the number of seeds require this much spacing. Sorry, this is the spacing. This is the plant to plant spacing. This is root to root spacing. So root to root spacing is already given, 0.75, and plant spacing we have to find out. That is 10,000 into 0.84 is the germination, because more number of seeds has to be planted, because 84% only germinates. Therefore, the spacing should be little less compared to the 100% germination. Therefore, if you multiply by this, then the plant to plant spacing will be equal to 0.25 meter. So now, one revolution of metering disc will lead to or forward travel of the planter will be equal to 0.25 into 54 meter, because the metering disc requires this much travel to put the 54 seeds, because each seed requires 0.25 meter spacing. Then 50 per speed, because if once it revolves the disc rotor, So it is sales, number of sales are there, 54 sales are there. So one rotation, 54 CD will drop. Therefore, 54 into 0.25 is 13.5 meter is the forward speed by the planter, not by the ground wheel. So now to travel 13.5 ground wheel has to rotate n times. Let it n is the revolution of the ground wheel, so that total travel is 13.5. So as we know that 10% skid is there, therefore pi d n dash is the evolution of the ground wheel. We have to find out if one revolution is done by the meter reading disc, how much n is the RPM of the ground wheel. So to find out, so you put this one, pi d n will be equal to forward travel, that is 13.5 will be calculated here. So putting that 13.5 here, because skid is there 1.1%, then therefore this will be the n will be equal to 13.5. So sorry, 13.5, 1.1 should not be here actually. The pi d n will be equal to 13.5 divided by 1.5, it's 1.1. So this is 1.1. So because the ground wheel actually will travel less, if 13.5 is the total travel, the ground wheel will be equal to 13.5 divided by 1.1, not this into 1.1. Okay, therefore the n dash will be equal to 13.5 divided by 1.1 into pi into 0.149, that is 7.9725 is the RPM of the ground wheel. That means 1:7.9725. Therefore the meter in disc to ground wheel angular speed ratio will be equal to 1:7.9725, or we can get it 1/7.9725:1, that is 0.125:1, which is the answer for the second part. So this is the angular speed ratio between the ground metering disc and ground wheel. So hope you understand. Please like and subscribe to my channel.